in the first perek in Yuma, it tells us that the first Beis HaMikdash was destroyed because the people were violating Avodah Zarah, Gilei Arayis, and Shfichas Damim. And then the Gemara said the second Beis HaMikdash was destroyed. They were not involved in Avodah Zarah, nothing like that. There was a lot of learning, but because of Sinas Chinam. So then the Gemara says, and which of the two Averis is worse, the Sinas Chinam or the three Averis Achamuras? So the Gemara says, Bira Tochiach. Look historically. You can figure out based on the history which is worse. The second Beis HaMikdash has been Chorev almost 2,000 years. The first Beis HaMikdash was only Chorev for 70 years. Then it was rebuilt right away. So obviously the Avera of Sinas Chinam is more Chomer than the three Averas together of Avodah Zarah, Gilei Arayis, and Shfichas Damim. Bira Tochiach. The Ramban in his commentary on Chumash points out that in the Chumash there's a Shinoi Loshen, there's a different expression used by the mitzvah of Avos Hashem. It says we have to Es Hashem Elokecho, and by Avos Yisrael it says we have to Lireyacho Kamoicha with a Lamed. Why is it by Avos Hashem Es Hashem Elokecho and we have to Lireyacho? So he says we'll use our terminology. We have expressions that we have that we picked up from the Chavis Halvavis. Chavis Halvavis says sometimes you have a Chavis Ha'ivarim, you have an obligation to eat matzah, to wear a tzitzis, to do an activity, and sometimes you have Chavis Halvavis, you have an obligation to have a certain attitude. So the Ramban writes that there's a basic, there's a fundamental difference between Avos Hashem and Avos Yisrael. Avos Hashem is a chavis al vavos. You have to develop a love for HaKadosh Baruch Hu in your heart. You have to ace Hashem alokecho. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is the object. He's supposed to be the object of our love. Ace Hashem alokecho. As opposed to, we have to l'racha kamoicha. I can't always develop a love for another person. Sometimes he's a despicable person. So the mitzvah of Avos Yisrael means we have to Lireyacha kamocha, you're obligated, it's a chavis ha'ivarim, it's not a chavis ha'alavavis. You're obligated to do activities, to take care of the other person's needs, and to treat them as if they would have been your own needs. I have to take care of, you have to lireyacha kamocha, whatever you would want people to do for you, you should do for the other person. There's such a gemara in Bav Metzia and Daf Lamed, where the gemara says, we learn that from the pasuk, there's a mitzvah of Hashavas Aveda. So the Chumash says, if you see Aveda Sachicha, and you'll forget it, you'll ignore it, lo sucha lehisalim. So the Pashab Shat and the Pasuk is, you shouldn't, if you'll see someone else's Aveda and you'll want to ignore it, so you're not allowed to ignore it. That's a simple Pshat. So the Torah Shebal Peh has an additional level of interpretation on the Pasuk. When you see another Yaveda of another Jew, sometimes you have the right to ignore it, and sometimes you say, so when do you have the right to ignore the other one's Aveda? It's the opposite from the Pshuto Shal Mikra, the Drosha of the Torah Shabbat. So the Gemara says there are cases, for example, the Gemara has an example, a Koyin Beveis HaKvaris. I'm a Koyin, and I'm driving by on the highway and there's a cemetery there and I see the car in front of me has a license plate Daf Yomi, so obviously he's a Jewish person. And I see his luggage fell off and it rolled into the cemetery. And I start honking him, he should stop, I can't get him to stop. So I write down his license plate, I can call up the police and they tell me who the owner of the car is with that license plate, I can find out. And I know where the Aveda is. I can go pick up the Aveda. If I'm going to wait till I call him, someone else may take the luggage. So is there a mitzvah? Would you say, Esa Dechaloi Sesa? Would you say, even though I'm a Kohen, I'm not allowed to be mitamei to Mesim, I'm not allowed to go on a Beis HaKvaris, but maybe it's permissible for me to be mitamei in the Beis HaKvaris in order to fulfill the mitzvah of Hashavas Aveda? So the Gemara says, I have the pasuk for his salamta, pamim shatam sam. You should not be mitamei le Mesim. So the Gemara said, that's ridiculous. I don't need a pasuk for that. The pasuk probably is telling me something else. For that, I don't need a pasuk because although we have a klal, ese dechaloi sese, but that's only an ese shebin adam lamokam, is dechaloi sese shebin adam lamokam. But midachina ni sura mikami mamayna. Mamayna means a mitzvah bin adam lachaveira. Isura means a mitzvah anisa bin adam lamokam. So tumas kahanim is an aver bin adam lamokam. And Hashavas Aved is a mitzvah bin Adam HaVeiroi. So the Gemara says we have a klal, an essay shebin Adam HaVeiroi doesn't have the power to be doiche, although it says shebin Adam HaMakam, midachin and isur, mikamim amon. Who ever heard of such a thing? So the Ramban explains, why is there such a klal? So he says, the side of all of the mitzvah shebin Adam HaVeiroi, Hashavas Aved, and Gemilas Chasanim and everything, the basis of all of the mitzvah shebin Adam HaVeiroi is the idea of ehavta l'racha kamocha, you have to treat other people's needs, the needs of other Jewish people. We belong to the same club together. You have to treat it as if it would have been your own need. So let's say the Kohen lost an Aveda in the Beis HaKvaros. Would you say the Kohen has been, I'm a Kohen, and my luggage fell off the car and went into the cemetery. I know where it is. Would you say I'm permitted to be Mitamela Mesim to retrieve my own Aveda? I'm not allowed to. So I'm obligated to take care of someone else's Aveda, to treat it as if it would have been my tzorech. I have to take care of other people's needs as if it would have been my own need. But if it would have been my own need, I wouldn't have any heta. So that's the whole basis of all of the mitzvah shebin al machaver, is this pasuk, you have to l'racha kamocha, you have to treat the other people's needs as if they were really your own needs. There's a famous expression that they say over the name of Rabbi Sol Salanter, that taking care of the gashmias of other Jews is a ruchnias for me. It's a mitzvah for me. It's a mitzvah to take care of someone else's gashmias. But once you see this Ramban, it's not exactly so. Taking care of the other person's gashmias, I have to treat it as if it's my gashmias, not that it's my ruchnias. Ramban says I have to treat the other one's needs as if it would have been my own need. So that's what the Gemara tells us, that the Baisheni was destroyed because of Sinas Chinam. And the fact that it wasn't rebuilt and it's almost 2,000 years shows that the Aveira of Sinas Chinam is more chomer than the other three together, the Tzir, Avodah Zarah, Gilui Ra'is, and Shvichas Damim. In Europe, they used to say over Yiddish folklore, they said over that one of the Chassidish Rebbes visited Eretz Israel years ago and he came back to Europe. And the Chassidim asked him, "Ooh, did you see the Maris HaMachpelah?" He said, "That's what they say. They claim that that's he visited. They say that's Maris HaMachpelah. Did you say the Kever Rachel?" "Yeah, he saw the Kever Rachel." That's what they say, it's Kever Rachel. Everything they asked him, "Did you see this?" He said, "That's what they say, that it's Kever Rachel," and so on. And then they asked him, "Did you see the old city, Yerushalayim?" So he said, "Yes." "Is it really?" He said, "Yeah, that's the old city." So they asked him, "How come you know for sure that the old city, Yerushalayim, is Yerushalayim?" And the others, they say, "That's what they say." So he said, because the Gemara says that it was the Baisheni was chayav because of Sinas Chinam, and the Sinas Chinam is still there. That's a siman muvik. The Sinas Chinam is still there. Unfortunately, we have a lot of Sinas Chinam, and Bira Tochir, the fact that Beis HaMikdash was not rebuilt, is an indication that how serious that Avera is. When the second Beis HaMikdash was built, so the Balabatim came to Zechariah Hanavi at the beginning of the Baisheni. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the Gemara tells us in the first paragraph of Yom, on a different daf, HaKadosh Baruch Hu was upset at Am Yisrael that they had an opportunity to return from Golda's Babel, and Ruba did not return. A very small percentage of the population came back there at Yisrael. So the Gemara says that when Shlomo HaMelech built the first place, HaMikdash, he already knew in advance that it was going to be destroyed. They were told on the occasion of the Chet HaMeraglim, "Atem b'chisem b'chia shal chinam, ani akva lechem b'chia l'doris." In the Chumash, it doesn't say so clearly that this was told to them on the occasion, but the Nitziv points out, it's a b'ferish apostik in Tehillim and in Yecheskel, that this was told to them in the days of Moshe Rabbeinu. The Nitziv interprets, maybe that's pshat, and the pasuk v'yulam chayon v'imalich vodius kol ha'aretz, he says maybe that's what it means. Kodesh Baruch Hu said, "I will send the Jews into Golus, and Kvod Hashem will be floating all over the world." But it says it beferish in Yecheskel in Atilim that they were told on the occasion of the Chet Hamraglim that the first Beis HaMikdash will not last forever. So Shlomo HaMelech wrote Beruach HaKodesh in Shir Asher Memchema, he nivna leha tiras kesef, imdelesi natsu ala luach orez. So the Gemara understands pshat in the pasuk. This is not pshuto shal mikra, this is an additional level of interpretation in the pasuk, that what it means is, imchema hi imyalu kachema, if at the end of the 70 years of Golas Bavel, all the Jews will return en masse back to Eretz Yisrael, then the second Beis HaMikdash will be like a tiras kesef. It'll be like a metal structure. Ein harekav sholed bo. Metal structures don't rot. Wooden houses rot. Metal doesn't rot. So the Gemara says on two levels, the second Beis HaMikdash will be everlasting. It won't be charev. And number two, rot will not set in the Jewish people, just like we always had Nevi'im. So we'll continue to have Nevi'im into the second Beis HaMikdash. However, in Delasi, if hardly anybody will show up, which was the case, hardly anybody came back from Golas Bavel, not so alalu ach oriz. So the second Beis HaMikdash will be like a wooden hut, like a wooden bungalow, sheharekev sholed bo. The wooden buildings can rot away, and the Gemara says in two meanings. Number one, the second Beis HaMikdash will be osed lehecharev, it will rot away, it will be destroyed. And number two, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will be angry at Bnei Yisrael, and he won't send any more Nevi'im. The Rabban Shalom loves us, so when we do our veris, he sends us Nevi'im to straighten us out, to give us tachocha. When he's angry at us, and we sin, so he's not going to straighten us out, he's going to leave us alone. So, that's what the Ravid writes in Hilchas Beis HaBchira, when Ezra built the second Beis HaMikdash, Yedeo Haya Ezra She'asid Leheicharev, he knew from day number one, he knew from the Pasuk in Shir HaShirim, that the second Beis HaMikdash is going to rot away. So, when the second Beis HaMikdash was built, so the three Nevi'im were there, Gimel Nevi'im, Ola Imayim above. Why were the three Nevi'im? So that the Gemara said, the Brisker Rav explains in that Gemara, why were they three Nevi'im? Because the Rebbeinu Shalom wanted them to rebuild the Beis HaMikdash, and the Halacha says, L'shich Nesidushu, Uvas HaShom, the Pasuk in Parshas Re'eh, he cannot build the Beis HaMikdash without authorization of a Navi. So they needed three Nevi'im. Each Navi, Chagas Char Malachi, gave a different prophecy about a different aspect of Binyan Bayisheni. And then they knew that the Bais is Asad Lehecharev. So they came and they asked the Ashayla of Zechariah HaNavi, it's in Trei Aser, that for 70 years they had a minig that they fasted on Tisha B'Av and Shivasa B'Tamas and some Gedalian Asar B'Tavis. So the Tisha B'Av, Shivasa B'Tamas is a Chodesh Arvi, this and here is Sivan Tamas. So they asked the Shaila, Ha'efke B'Chodesh HaChamishi, should I still cry on Tisha B'Av? Av is the fifth month, should I still cry on Tisha B'Av? Like we were crying, we had a minig for 70 years that we fasted on Tisha B'Av, etc. Should we still continue that minig? So the Navi answers, some Haravi, with some Hachamishi, with some Hashvi, with some Hasiri, some Haravi, the Gemara says in Rosh Hashanah and Shivasa B'Tamas, some Hachamishi, the first day in the fifth month is Tisha B'Av, some Hashvi is some Gedalia, and some Hasiri is Hasar B'Tavis, the 10th month. Yir l'sasan l'simcha l'beis Yisrael. And then, so the Gemara said, there's a problem over here. The Navi refers to these fast days as a tainus. So it sounds like he's endorsing it. He's approving it. They should still continue to fast. Tomarvi. And then he says, yir l'sasan l'simcha, they should celebrate. And then he tells them, and then he continues, the Navi Zachari continues to say, HaTzom Tzamtuni Oni, did you ask me? Did I, Rabbi Shalom says, did I instruct you to fast on Tisha B'Av and Asar B'Tavis? I gave you all the mitzvah. I gave you Shabbos and Kashrus and Taras HaMishpacha and Shiluach Avadim and Ben Adam Lachaver, Ben Adam Lamach. You didn't listen to me. So I destroyed the Beis HaMikdash and I sent you into Gola. So you're not listening to me, so do whatever you don't please. You want to fast, you want to eat, do whatever you want. So the Gemara Rosh Hashanah asks, the Navi seems to be giving three different psukim. Correlates home, he endorses the fast days and he's approving it. So it sounds like he's recommending that you should fast. Then he says, you the source of the simcha, you make a yontif out of these days. And then he says, do whatever you want. Ratzim asanim, ratzim asanim. So the Navi talks out of three sides of his mouth at the same time. Which is it? So the Gemara tells you what the psak is, that when you have a Beis HaMikdash, then you should have yamim tovim. You don't observe any avelus. And when you don't have a Beis HaMikdash and there's a gzeres hashmad against the Jewish people, then the tannis became more serious than before. Until they asked the shaila of the Navi and he declared Tzomer Avi, so it was only a minig that they fasted. They started a minig on their own. Now that the Navi approved it, Beruach HaKodesh, so So now the mechuyev tefes medivri kabbalah. Medivri kabbalah kedivri Torah dami. So it's more serious. The Rabbi Natam is quoted in the Chuvas Maimini. In the end of every section in the Rambam, they have Chuvas Maimini. Chuvas Maimini has nothing to do with the Rambam. These are Chuvas of the Balei HaTosfos. Many of them are from the Maharam Rutenberg and others, some other Balei HaTosfos, on topics that are discussed in the Rambam, and that's safer. Like the Ahavas Yisrael on the bottom of the page has nothing to do with the Rambam. The Ahavas Yisrael always tells you what Rashi and Tosfos say about the topics that the Rambam writes on top of the page. But he's not a commentary on the Rambam. He's telling what the Balei HaTosfos say. So the Ahavas Yisrael also has nothing to do with the Rambam. These are Chuvas by the Balei HaTosfos on topics that are in that section in the Rambam. So in there's a Chuvas Maimini that's quoted in Shulchan Aruch, where the Rabbi Natam writes in the Chuva that when Tainis some Gedalia used to be Divrei Kabbalah, when they were Mukhiyif to face Divrei Kabbalah, so the Gemara has an expression, Divrei Kabbalah ki Divrei Torah Damyan. So then it would only be permissible to eat on some Gedalia, like on Yom Kippur, only if the person would be at least Sofik Sakana or worse, Sofik Sakana Vaday Sakana. But you wouldn't allow a Chodesh Eim B'Sakana to eat. But now, since Bizman Hazeh, it's Ratz Misanim, Ratzai Misanim, and just that the Ba'ak says, Kvash Yaviu Alayi Chayva, the meaning is that we all fast, so then it's no longer Divrei Kabbalah, it's only Mitam Minig, so then we allow a Chodesh Eim B'Sakana to eat. So that's what the Gemara says, the three Chiluki Dinim, that when there's a Beis HaMikdash, you're not supposed to fast, you're supposed to celebrate over the fact that we have a Beis HaMikdash. When there's not Beis HaMikdash and there's a Gzeres HaShmad, the Gzeres against the Jewish people, then you mukhiv to fast Medivrei Kabbalah. And the Ramban writes in the Torah Sa'odom that when you mukhiv to fast Medivrei Kabbalah, all the Taneisim are like Tisha B'Av. Leila Kiyoma for 24 hours and all the Hamisha Inuyim. The reason why on Shivasa B'Tamis and some Gedalia we only fast in the daytime, we only observe the Yisra Achidah Shtir, we don't observe the other prohibitions of Nilas HaSandal and Rechitz and Sikh and so on, is because it's totally Ratz Masana, Ratzai Masanim, just Krasha Yavu Alay Chayva. The meaning is that we fast. So the meaning only was that Achidah Shtir and only Bayom. But when it's really Medivrei Kabbalah, then Mechuyev to observe all the Hamisha Inuim. Rav Soloveitchik said that during the war years in Europe, many of the Rabbanim told the Balavatim that the Mechuyev to fast the other Taneisim, like Tisha B'Av, all the Hamisha Inuim, and Leila Kiyoma, because there was a Gzeres Hashmad against the Jews. It's not based on Migdash, and Gzeres Hashmad, then Mechuyev to fast Medivrei Kabbalah. So when the Balavatim came and they asked the Shaila of the Nevi'im and the Beis HaMikdash, they asked the Charya, the other Nevi'im, are we still obligated to fast? Until then, the minig was that they fasted on these different Taneisim, Tzomar Aviv, Tzomar Hamishi. It was a minig. But then once they asked the Navi and he said, Tzomar Aviv, Tzomar Hamishi, he elevated the level of the Chiyav to the level of Divrei Kabbalah. Divrei Kabbalah means a Chiyav that has the endorsement of the Bezon Shalmailo because it's recorded in Tanakh. And the only had to eat would be a Chodesh Yesh B'Sakonim. So the Gemara says that this halacha, that it depends Ratzim Masanim, Ratzim Masanim, only applies to the other Taneisim. And Tisha B'Av, because so many tragedies occurred on Tisha B'Av, five different tragedies, so that's why when Mechuyev to fast, Bizman Hazeh, the whole day, with all the Chamisha Inuyim, even though there's no Gzeres Hashmat. Aydi Gemara says Shavasa B'Tam is the worst of five tragedies, and Gemara says no, but Churban Beis Hamikdash twice, that's a tragedy on top of a tragedy. So they singled that Tisha B'Av is different. So there's a Mechaber in Hilchas Tisha B'Av where the Shulchan Aruch writes that on Tisha B'Av everybody has to fast unless one is a Chodesh Ein Bo Sakana. Chodesh Ein Bo Sakana is permitted to eat. So there's a Taz where the Taz disagrees. He says, how can you say Chodesh Ein Bo Sakana is permitted to eat? The Chuvas Maimon quoted the Rabbeinu Tam that when some Gedalia used to be, if some Gedalia would be Medivrei Kabbalah, it would only be permissible to eat if you have a Chodesh Yesh B'Sakana, because Divrei Kabbalah, Kedivrei Torah Damyan. But because today it depends on Ratz Misano Etzayim Misanim, it's only Kvar Shav Yolai Chayva, so therefore you allow a Chol Hashem B'Sakana. But the Gemara says that this Ratz Misanim doesn't apply to Tisha B'Av. Tisha B'Av is Medirei Kabbalah. So you mukhif to face Medirei Kabbalah, so it should only be Mutta to eat if he's a Chol Hashem B'Sakana. So he says, even though the Ramban says that a Chol Hashem B'Sakana may eat the Mechab Gadif and the Ramban, he says we should be Machma like the Rabbeinu Tam. That Shuvas Maimini quotes the Rabbeinu Tam, that Dibre Kabbalah, Dibre Teradam, only Chadu Sheish B'Sakon. So the Avnei Nezer has a tshuva. Someone published a collection of lectures, Shiurim, that Rav Soloveitchik gave on Tisha B'Av, comments on the kinnis that we recite. And in the beginning, the first few pages, they have Shiurim on Dinei Tisha B'Av. So they write down the name of Rav Soloveitchik, that what's the relevance, Halacha L'maaseh, of declaring that Tisha B'Av is a Taina Sibur. The significance is that it's only permissible to eat if you're Chodesh Yesh B'Sakana. So it could well be Rabbi Soloveitchik said that, but it's not correct. We don't paskin like that, and I'm sure he himself never paskin like that either. He must have said it off the cuff. He wasn't thinking, and he said this in the beginning of the year. It was an avala that they printed in his name. It's an avala that people print things in the name of Rabbi Soloveitchik without realizing that that's not really his opinion. He may have said it in the lecture in the year. But it's but he never paskin like that for sure. You know, everybody knows that a Chol Hashem B'Sakana is permitted to eat on Tisha B'Av. So the Avnei Nezer has a tshuva where he explains that the Taz wrote his commentary before the Rashbo on Rosh Hashanah was printed. It wasn't yet available. It was just a manuscript. Truth of the matter, even if the Rashbo on Rosh Hashanah would have been printed, the Taz probably wouldn't have a copy. The Taz was a very poor man, and he didn't have so many svarim. The Shach had access to everything under the sun. Pile Plem. The Shach died at a young age and he had access to all the Svarim, even the Svarim that were printed in Greece just a few years before. How did he get it? He lived in Vilna. How did he get the Svarim from Greece? But the Taz hardly had any Svarim. So the Avnei Nezer says, you look in the Rashba and Rosh Hashanah on that Gemara, the Rashba points out that this distinction that the Gemara says, because on Tisha B'Av Huchbul Abo Hatzaris, five tragedies occurred, and the Churban Beis Hamikdash twice over occurred. So that's why Tisha B'Av is different. That's not Medivrei Kabbalah. That doesn't say in the Navi. The Navi, they're all put together. Some Raviv, some Hamishi. So Medivrei Kabbalah, Tisha B'Av is also totally Ratzim Misanim, Ratzim Misanim. The fact that it's not optional, that's only Midrabbanan. And on a din de Rabbanan, that's a din. A Tainus Tziba de Rabbanan, the Chol Hashem B'Sakana is permitted to eat. There is a difference between Tisha B'Av and the other Tanaisim. The Gemara makes a difference. And Tisha B'Av, Ma'u Baris and Manikas have to fast. Masha'enikain on the other Tanaisim, they don't have to fast. So the Taz says, there you have it. Ma'u Baris and Manikas, Achelu She'en B'Sakon, and they still have to fast on Tisha B'Av. So the Pashto says that that's not correct. That's not correct. The difference is the following. There is a Gemara in Tainus, Mishnayis in Tainus, that when there's Atziras Gishamim, when there's no rain, years ago, when there's no rain in Eretz Yisrael, so nothing, the crops are not going to grow, the animals are going to die, and the people are going to die. It's going to be a sakonis nefoshes. Now that they know how to desalinate water, so it just cost a lot of money. So now, a few years ago, the younger rabbanim who were in their rabbanut and Eretz Yisrael wanted to be goyz atainis because they are satsiris kishamim. So the older rabbanim were laughing at the younger rabbanim. Said, what are you talking about? There's no sakonis defoshes now at Sirius Gishamim. It'll just cost a lot of money. They know how to desalinate water, so the problem will be solved. The only time it goes at Tainus when there's at Sirius Gishamim and people are going to die when there's sakonis. But Bismanuzet, there's no sakonis. So in the days of the Tanaim, there would be goes at Tainus for at Sirius Gishamim because people can die. So the Mishnah says that first because of three Tanaisim, Sheni v'chamisha v'sheni, then another time, still doesn't rain, 2 weeks later, still, again, Sheni v'chamisha v'sheni, and then there goes a tiny six tanes, Monday, Thursday, Monday, Thursday, Monday, Thursday, Monday, seven tanes. So first you have three, then you have three, then you have seven. So the Gemara quotes three brises. What's the status of Muboros and Manikas? So in the first three tanes, it's a tiny the Rabban and Kal, so we allow the Muboros and Manikas to eat. The second unit of three Tanaisim, Sheni Machamisha Visheni, is a Tainus de Rabbanan Chomor. So we don't permit Muboros and Manikas to eat. the third unit of seven Tanais, Monday, Thursday, the third one is Mochamer, but then we allow them to eat. The Gemara says, why? Should be a Kalvachamer from the second unit of three, that it's a Tainus Darabana Chom, if it still doesn't rain, and it goes a Tainus seven Tanaisim. So for sure, the Mubaris and Manika should have to fast. So the Gemara says, no, because we know they can't fast seven Tanaisim in a row, Shein v'chamisha in a row. After fasting three, they're going to fast another seven. They won't be able to last till the end and see the all or nothing. So since by the time it comes to the last few of the seven, they'll already be for sure achol l'shem b'sarkana, so they're not mechuyif to fast and even in the beginning. So what did the Gemara tell us over here? What's the klal? So the klal seems to be like this. Achol l'shem b'sarkana is allowed to eat on a tainus d'rabbanan. The only time you need achol l'shem b'sarkana, safik sarkana, that's on Yom Kippur, or if the Tanaisim and Divrei Kabbalah, if the Bizman that the Divrei Kabbalah, Divrei Kabbalah, Kedivrei Torah Damyan, so then the Rabbein Tam says in the Tshuva, in the Tshuva's Maimini, that you would only be permitted to eat if you're Chayla with a suffix Sakana. So, a Chayla Shem Sakana is permitted to eat. Do you automatically declare every single Muberis of Manika as a Chayla Shem Sakana? They say no, we have to judge each woman individually. If she's fainting, if she doesn't feel well, if she can't, Cholishem B'sakana means a person can't function normally. So if they can't function normally, then they are Cholishem B'sakana. But do you automatically declare every Muberis and Manika as a Cholishem B'sakana? So if it's a Tainas Derabbanan Ka like the other Tanais, and then we say automatically, every Muberis and Manika is a Cholishem B'sakana. And Tisha B'Av is a Tainas Derabbanan Chamur, so you don't automatically declare every Muberis and Manika as a Cholishem B'sakana. You see how she feels. If she's fainting and laying in bed all day long, then she is a Chodeshem B'sakana, then she may eat. Then the Taz has another argument that Bein Hashmashes on Tisha B'Av were Machmir, and on the other Tanaisim were Mekel. So it must be because Tisha B'Av is Divrei Kabbalah, and Divrei Kabbalah ki Divrei Torah Damin, so Safik L'Chumra. And the other Tanaisim is not be Divrei Kabbalah, it's only the Rabbanan. A Minik is only the Rabbanan, so Safik D'Rabbanan L'Kula. So the Avnanesis says that's not the reason why, that's not true. Tisha B'Av today is only be the Rabbanan, like the Rashba wrote there in Rosh Hashanah. It's not be Divrei Kabbalah. Why is Safik Asar? So he said, no, because Tisha B'Av is also Leila Kiyomah. So you have to be concerned about two Tisha B'Av, two Bein Hashmashesin. So if you want to be Mekel on the first Bein Hashmashes of Leil Tisha B'Av, because Dina Kelaila, then you, if you want to be Mekel, that you're allowed to eat on the Bein Hashmashes entering in the Tisha B'Av. Why? Because Bein Hashmashes is Yom, then you got to be Machmer on the second Bein Hashmashes. You want to be Mekel on the second Bein Hashmashes, because it's like Lada, then you have to be Machna first Bein Hashmashes. So you can't be Mekel on both. You don't say Sveka Derabona Lekula by Tarte Disasri. And he quotes from the Avnei Nezer quotes from the last Simon and Chelak Aleph Yeredeya, Simon Kuf Yer Aleph, that you can't say by Shtei Kederis, you can't say Sveka Derabona Lekula by Tarte Disasri. He says the other Tanesim, you don't fast by Yom HaBalayla, so you're only concerned about one Bein Hashmashes. Bein Hashmashes of the end of the Tanis. So then you say, Safik Darabana Lekula, he can be Mekel. But Tisha B'Av, because you fast Leilu Kiyomo, so you have to consider, you have to think about both of the Bein Hashmashes. So it's a Tata, you can't be Mekel on both, and you can't be arbitrarily Mekel on one, Machman on the other one, Mehechatesa. So you have to be Machman on both, like Shnei Shvilin, like the Din of Shnei Shvilin. The many cheerful aspects of Hilchas Tainus and Hilchas Tisha B'Av and Hilchas Shavasa B'Tamuz, we hope the Beis HaMikdash will be built today, Tzoy Hashem, and all of this will be just pilpulim. But there's a lot to learn in the halachas. Everyone should be healthy. Oh,